Hi my creatives, in this video tutorial you're going to learn how to make this adorable little crab. Now it has one claw and one other pincher and then six skinny legs. So you will need worsted weight yarn, which I'm using Vanna's Choice in Brick, but you could use any Karen Simply Soft, whatever worsted weight you use. And then I have an H8 5mm hook, safety eyes, you'll need stuffing, scissors, and a pattern, which can be found on elenahuffmeyer.com. So for row one, we're going to make a slip stitch, then chain seven, work two single crochets in the second chain from hook. So we're skipping this one, working in the second, making two single crochets in the same stitch, single crochet in the next four, and I just work in the upper part of the legs. Three single crochet in the last chain. So whenever you're turning or making a corner, you make three single crochet, and then I pull my tail tight to close up the little hole. Then working on the opposite side of the chain, we're going to single crochet four stitches. So one, two, and I hold my tail on top to kind of weave it in as I go. Three, four, and single crochet in the last stitch. Do not join, we're going to work in rounds. Rounds. So then, just moving my marker up. Row two is three single crochets in the first stitch. So one, and after the first one, I'm gonna mark my round. Two, three, so three in the first, and that's our corner. Single crochet in the next six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Three single crochets in the next stitch. That's our corner, so we'll do three in the same. So a three single crochet increase, and then work six stitches. So one, two, three, four, five, six. And the next one is the first stitch where we have our stitch marker. So this is what you have so far. Looks like an oval. Third round is single crochet in the first stitch. I like to make a stitch and then move my marker. And then three in the next. So three single crochet increase here for our corner. Single crochet in the next eight. One, two, three, three single crochet in the next stitch, for our corner here, and then single crochet in each of the next seven. So two, three, four, five, six, seven. Good, always count your stitches so you make sure you have the right amount. It can throw you off when working these patterns. Count your stitches. Row four, round four is single crochet one in the first two stitches. So one, two, three single crochets in the next. Single crochet 10. and you can see it's starting to take more shape and starting to curl here. Then we three single crochet in the next stitch and work 8 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If you're with me, you have the right amount of stitches, you're doing great. So this is how it's looking at the end of round 4. Round 5 is you single crochet in the first 3, 2, 3, then 3 here in the next, 3 single crochets in the next, single crochet 1 in each of the next 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 3 single crochets in the next for our edge, corner, and then work in the next 9. So 1 single crochet, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 2 single crochet in the first. So after our first, I'm going to move my stitch marker. Make 2 in the first stitch and then single crochet around. So you will have a total of 30 stitches here. See you at the end of this round. Just single crochet flat. We're at the end of round 6. Round 7 is half double crochet around. So half double crochet is yarn over, put your hook in, yarn over, pull through, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through all 3. That's your half double crochet, and it's a little bit taller than a single crochet. Just move our stitch marker, half double crochet around. Yarn over, put your hook in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 3. Half double crochet around. So we have half double crocheted around. Now on round 8, we're gonna back post single crochet. This might be a new stitch for you. So we're going to go through the back of the first 2 underneath the 2 loops. Then 2 through the front to back of the next, underneath 2 loops, yarn over, pull through that post, yarn over, pull through 2 loops on your hook. So you're working around the post, so essentially this section, you're working around that. So back to front, stick your hook in underneath 2 loops, front to back, stick your hook in, yarn over, pull through, there we go, yarn over, pull through 2, single crochet, back post single crochet. Let's just do that around. Practice makes better. And it makes a beautiful effect, like this little braided area here. And also what it does is folds the fabric. So we're making a sharp fold. So it's gonna be like a dome and then flat, like here. It's flat. So single crochet, back post single crochet around. You can rewind as well, replay, watch again and again until you get it. Our last single front post, sorry, back post single crochet. Okay, here we go. Beautiful. Looks really cool. Reminds me of a sock, actually. Okay. So then round 9 is single crochet and then single crochet 4, then decrease around. So we're going to work in the same stitch here on this one here. And I put my marker in. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, decrease. 1, 2, 3, 4, single crochet decrease. 1, 2, 3, 4, decrease. Round 11 is single crochet 2 and then decrease. So 1, 2, decrease, 1, 2, decrease, 1, 2, decrease around. So at the end of row 11, we're going to attach our eyes and also stuff the body. So what I do is I pull the yarn long, may even remove the marker. So we want to put the eyes somewhere like that. So that's between rows 5 and 6. And I have here my 6mm eyes. You could buy them online or at the craft store, AC Moore. So between rows 5 and 6, and you can place these black eyes first, see how they look. You don't have to attach them right away. So between 5 and 6, so this is the center line, so we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here we're going to attach our eyes, see where it looks nice. And they should be 4 stitches apart. And that's just a guide, so you could put them as much apart or close together as you'd like. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And if we like that, we can keep it. If you don't like it, you can move it. I wonder if I should move it over one. Yeah, I think that's better. Okay, now that I like the placement, I'll go ahead and take my white washer. Stick this out, squeeze, but not too much. Almost to the end. Take the white washer and squeeze. Okay. They're really hard to get off, if you can ever get them off. And then I have some yarn endings here that I like to stuff with. I'm gonna go with my lighter colors first. so I keep my yarn scraps. Nice stuff. You can make it soft, or you could stuff it really well so it's firm. You could put a little bell in there, a rattle, whatever you want to do. You want to stuff it a little bit more. It's a good way to get rid of your yarn ends. I don't really like using stuffing because when I weave my ends in, the stuffing shows through and it's just a pain because I have to keep pulling them out. Maybe a little bit more. That's great. I love using yarn ends. Okay. So now just continue finishing the hole. So you're on the last stitch, and for row 12, we're just going to decrease all around. So just do single crochet two together. So we single crochet two together around until we had six stitches left. So then we can join, leave a long tail for sewing, sewing the hole shut. I like to use my blunt eye needle for that. Here it is. There's plastic ones also, so I just put my yarn through. It's a very large hole, large eye. And then I'm just going to go in through the back loops. So you see the front loop and the back loop. I'm just gonna go through the back loops. Close that up, then weave in our tail. And go in all different directions so the tail doesn't have a chance to come out. Back and forth, not too tight. Sometimes I even like to use my hook to grab the tail and pull it in. Okay, here's the body. Now let's work on the legs. We're gonna do the pinchers first, the big guys. So we're going to chain two, six single crochet in the second chain from the hook. So you never work in the first because it'll be too tight, so you always work in the second. We're gonna give this six single crochets here. Three, four, five, six. So you're going to, on the second round, you're gonna do one and then increase in the next round. So one, you could put a stitch marker, you don't have to. I feel like a stitch marker makes it more mindless for me, that I don't have to count the stitches, I just have to repeat the pattern. So one, increase, one, increase. One increase. You should have nine stitches here. What I like to do at this point is See, there's a little hole there. I don't like that, so I'm just gonna pull my tail and it closes the hole. Magic. Okay, so row three, we're going to single crochet two and then increase around. So my mantra is one, two, increase for every stitch. So one, two, increase. One, two, increase. Now that my stitch marker fell out, I know I did two, so I did one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. You're supposed to have 12 stitches at the end of this round, so that's great. And for round four, we're going to single crochet around, so just single crochet 12. 1, 10, 11, 12. You could see it's already starting to, if your work is like this, I call this the wrong side and this is the right side. It's not because it's right or wrong, because to differentiate, but I like the way this side looks, so I'm just gonna push it out like this, and I like to squeeze my tail in there so it's not in my way. For round five, we're going to single crochet three and then decrease around, so then we have 9 stitches. So we do 1, 2, 3, and then the decrease gives us a 4th stitch. So that's 4, 5, 6, 7. The decrease gives us an 8. For row 5, we're going to single crochet 2 and then decrease around. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, decrease. 1, 2, decrease. For row 6, we're going to single crochet 1 and then decrease around. So 1, decrease, 1, decrease, 1, single crochet 2 together. For rows 7 through 11, we're going to single crochet around. Five, six. So here we are. End of row 11, I'm just going to join. Leave a long tail for sewing, fasten off, and that's our first arm. You don't have to stuff it, so it's gonna sit like that. Make another one, and then we're going to work on the legs. So we have to make 7 of these, 6 legs and 1 pincher. You're going to chain 8. Single crochet in the second chain from hook, single crochet in the next 5, three single crochet in the last stitch, working on the opposite end, on the opposite side, you will single crochet 6. You join the slip stitch, leave a, then you can either sew it together or you can slip stitch it together. To make it a little bit faster, I'm going to slip stitch it. So I have the right side here and the wrong side. I'm gonna put the folded, so the wrong side is on the inside and the right side is out. I'm just going to take my hook, put it through the first two stitches, and then put it through the back two stitches. The first one's a little tight, but the rest are okay. Keep slip stitching. And then we're going to close this leg. Yarn over, leave a long tail for sewing. Make six more of these. Then you're just going to sew them onto the body. And you're done. I just hold them in place. Some people like to pin them in place. And I go through both layers, so the front and the back. Front and back. Let's see what it looks like. I'm gonna stitch it a little bit more. Make it look the way I want. So I'm just gonna grab up here. Then I put my needle and stick it through the center. So I'm gonna bring all my yarns to the center, tie them together, and stuff them back in. Okay, so this little leg, that's a good spot. I'm just gonna hold it in place and stitch it. It's nice that the yarn is all one color, so you don't really see all the threads. Stick my needle through the center. If I like the way the leg is coming out, you could always manipulate. So then I tie these off so they don't come loose. Not too tight, because then it pulls the rest of the fabric. And again with my crochet hook, put my hook in, go through the center, grab the two yarns, and I pull them in. And if you have a better way or faster or something easier, please let me know. I would love to make this process faster. Okay, so that's that. Just keep making legs and attaching them. Did you like this video? Please let me know in the comments below and share with your friends so they too can unleash the creative within. Patterns, ideas, and handmade items can be found on olenahofmeyer.com.